Hey, my name is Bill Marion, and we are ascending up Pikes Peak, and it is a beautiful day. It's cold, but it's a beautiful day. This is a Nose for Life. So we're here at the first overlook, waiting on Anna and Oz to meet us up here at the top. We got Nathan and Crystal with us, and Madison with us, and of course, Carolyn's always with me. This is an amazing location. This was sort of a bucket list for me to bring my family out west, and we never were able to take the trip we wanted to take out here. But hey, we got here thanks to Anna. This is where her and Oz decided to get married, and so here we are.
Pikes Peak is the highest summit of the southern front range of the Rocky Mountains in North America. The front range runs north-south between Casper, Wyoming and Pueblo, Colorado, and rises nearly 10,000 feet above the Great Plains. Long's Peak, Mount Evans, and Pikes Peak are the most prominent peaks visible from the Interstate 25 corridor, which means when you're driving on Interstate 25 in Colorado, you have an amazing view of some of the most beautiful mountains in the world. The front range also includes the highest peaks along the eastern edge of the Rockies, and the summit of Pikes Peak is higher than any point in the United States east of its longitude. Pikes Peak is in Pike National Forest. That includes over 1 million acres covering 5 different Colorado counties.
I said the same thing at Garden of the Gods when I would show Pikes Peak in the distance. It has to be one of the most photogenic mountains in the world. It just looks perfect. It just looks absolutely amazing. We're here at Pike National Forest. It's about 33 degrees. A little warmer in this spot, it feels like. There's snow on the ground, but it's blue skies, and so we're okay. There's some patches of ice here and there, but they seem to have it under control. Lots of traffic. It's always busy here.
Pikes Peak is a designated National Historic Landmark, and nearly 6 million people visit the region each year, making it the most visited mountain in North America, and it's second only to Mount Fuji as the most visited mountain in the world. And who knows? It might even be home to Bigfoot. During this video, we'll be traveling along Pikes Peak Highway, 19 miles of mountain terrain with lots of scenic pull-offs and some amazing, breathtaking views. While you're watching this video, leave a comment and let us know about your mountain adventures. This amazing mountain is named after Zebulon Montgomery Pike, a U.S. Army officer who led 2 expeditions to the region under the authority of President Thomas Jefferson after the Louisiana Purchase back in 1806. Pike's expedition was one of several ordered by Jefferson, including the famous Lewis and Clark expedition. Pike never made it to the actual summit, but in 1810 he published an account of all of his expeditions, and the book was a big hit all over the world. Pike was really popular. Unfortunately, Pike died in the War of 1812 at the Battle of York, but long before Pike, a band of the Ute people known as the Tabawatch called this mountain home. Tabawatch means people of Sun Mountain. Pikes Peak went through a few name changes before 1890. It was known as El Capitan, Grand Peak, Great Peak, James Peak, Long Mountain, and then finally Pikes Peak. The first recorded ascent was in 1820 by Edwin James, and the first woman to climb the mountain was Miss Julia Archibald Holmes in 1858. As for Bigfoot sightings, well, sightings of a strange, tall, furry creature were being reported around Pikes Peak in the early 1800s, and they continue to this very day. More on that later. Here's some mountain peak lingo for you that may come in handy in your next game of trivia pursuit. A 14er is a mountain peak with an elevation of at least 14,000 feet. In the United States, there are 96 14ers, all of which are west of the Mississippi. 58 of these are in Colorado. Well, sort of. Not everyone agrees on the exact way a 14er should be measured, so there's that. But that discussion is for another video on someone else's channel. Regardless, it's safe to say that over half of the mountains in the United States that are 14,000 feet or higher are in Colorado. In 1893, Catherine Lee Bates ascended Pikes Peak, and she was so inspired by the breathtaking views of the surrounding mountains and sweeping plains that she wrote a poem that ultimately became America the Beautiful. Like I mentioned earlier, sightings of the elusive Hairy Scary, better known as Bigfoot, around Pikes Peak go all the way back to the 1800s. and they're still being reported. After multiple reports of encounters, a Bigfoot crossing sign was finally placed along Pikes Peak Highway around 1990. And no, it's not a joke. Here's the sign warning of Bigfoot. Colorado has been known for a very long time as one of the most active places in the country for Bigfoot, with hundreds of sightings reported in this amazing state. Pike Peak sits in El Paso County, where there has been several reported sightings of Bigfoot. Back in 2006, near Fort Carson, a soldier reported seeing a 7-foot-tall creature. Fort Carson seems to be a Bigfoot hotspot, as reports of sightings in that area go back to the early 1990s. In fact, it seems like every region across the state of Colorado at some point or another has reported seeing Bigfoot. Around Pikes Peak, encounters with Bigfoot are reported as friendly, and in some cases, the shy, mysterious monster leaves gifts for campers, but doesn't like cameras for some reason. The sign says, "Posted for our safety." I can't say that the sign made me feel safe or cautious, but I did feel more informed, I guess. I don't know. We didn't see Bigfoot. But I admit I was a little distracted by the beauty of Pikes Peak, and I wasn't really looking for Bigfoot. If there is a Bigfoot, I'm sure he's grateful for the signs. So, do you believe in Bigfoot? Have you ever seen a Bigfoot? Let us know in the comments. Let me take just a few seconds to welcome back all of our subscribers. We make videos just for you. If this is the first time to our channel, welcome, and I hope you're enjoying this video. We make a variety of videos, so there's always something for everyone. Please consider subscribing, clicking the bell for notifications, and leaving a comment. We want to hear what you have to say, and it really helps our channel grow. Do you love the Rocky Mountains? Be sure to check out our Colorado Adventures playlist. I'll leave a card just for you at the end of this video. Now, let's get back to Pikes Peak.
A lot of our videos, and I sure hope that you do, and thanks for watching. You know that most of our videos are in the Appalachian Mountains, east of the Mississippi, and usually the elevation there at the most is between 6,000 and at the most 7,000 feet. We're beyond that now, and what we're noticing, it's harder to breathe, and it's very cold.
At the peak, the partial pressure of oxygen is only about 60% of that at sea level. A faster rate of respiration is required by humans and animals not acclimated to this altitude. The summit of Pikes Peak has a polar climate due to its elevation. Snow is a possibility anytime year-round, and thunderstorms with high winds gusting up to 100 miles per hour are more common in the afternoons. It's visually stunning. I'm not saying it's the most photogenic mountain in the world, I guess that's subjective, but it really does get your attention. From the Great Plains, it can be seen for miles and miles away. And back during the 1850s and 1860s, it was a landmark for wagon trains heading west.
So the bottom line is I've been out here a total of 5 minutes and I am freezing. So I'm sorry that this isn't the best shot. This is as far as we can go. We're still 6 miles from the top, but I understand why the Park Service isn't letting us go any farther, because it's dangerous. No matter how clear it is, snow from here in among the trees is blowing onto the road and it builds up into ice and it's getting very dangerous. I'm glad we're having to turn around, but wow, Pikes Peak. Impressive, majestic, beautiful, worth your time. Fantastic.
In If you're planning on visiting Pikes Peak, I strongly recommend visiting between May and October because of the weather. Here's why. In midsummer, the temperature in Colorado Springs could be 90 degrees Fahrenheit, but the temperature at the top of Pikes Peak is only 50, so you can imagine how cold it is on Pikes Peak during the winter months. We were visiting Colorado in November due to my oldest daughter's wedding in Estes Park. From Estes Park to this part of Colorado is a very difficult 2 or more hours drive thanks to terrible traffic in Denver. You can actually take a scenic route through the mountains, and normally that's what Carolyn and I would do, but there simply wasn't enough time. Not to mention that the weather in the Rocky Mountains this time of year is unpredictable. So we took the interstate and endured Denver traffic. We spent a few hours at the Garden of the Gods, which was amazing, followed by a quick visit to Del Taco, and then we started at Pikes Peak. Now I'm sharing all of this to explain that November is not the best time to see everything Pikes Peak has to offer. In fact, it might even be one of the worst times. First, it's 2020, so there's that, but we didn't have access to the summit of Pikes Peak due to road conditions. It isn't just cold there, it's like Arctic cold. And there were times that the road conditions even scared me, and I'm not spooked easily by snow and ice. But here's the thing, even as limited as we were on the visit, it was still worth the time and money. And yes, like everything else these days, it's going to cost a little money to drive up the mountain, but it was worth it. Every single second we spent on the mountain was amazing, but there wasn't enough time. I left wanting more, and I'm really hoping that we get back soon. We just didn't get enough. So even if you happen to be in the area for any reason, make time for Pikes Peak. See whatever you're able to see with the time that you have. Trust me, you won't regret it.
The hardest part about being here in Colorado at Pikes Peak is not enough time. And so I wouldn't say that this is the perfect advice. This is just something that I've noticed. You want to give yourself plenty of time, even if it means skimping on some luxury and food. Make sure you have enough time. I mean, we're here for the wedding. The wedding was great. Everything was amazing. But the truth of the matter is that if I were planning to come out here for a vacation, I would rather have 10 to 14 days out here and stay in the most modest, accommodations than to be out here for 5 days at the Ritz. Because time, you need time here. There's just not enough time to do Garden of the Gods, Pikes Peak in one day. I mean, really, you want a few days for just this part of Colorado. Colorado is amazing. So the other thing is, do you come in the summer or do you come in the winter? And of course, that's kind of like a given. If you are into skiing and things like that, you want to be here in the winter when you can do winter sports. But if you're really wanting to do the hiking thing, I definitely would recommend coming in the middle of summer so that you have access to everything up here. Because again, we can't go to the top of Pikes Peak because of the weather and the winter schedule. You don't have as much time, and it gets dark quick. I mean, it's getting dark at like 4 o'clock, so you don't have a lot of time to see a whole lot. I would plan for the hiking, outdoor adventure, fishing, lots of fishing here too. I would plan for that, of course, well in advance, and give yourself the heat of summer to be out here.
Thank you so much for watching. If you've enjoyed this video, share it on your favorite social media platform. Don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button. My name is Bill Marion, and this is A Nose for Life. Hey, if you have time, check out some of these other videos.